All right, so people get the chance to vote on increasing leverage up to 3x. Normally, I stay at 1x and under, and people don't like the slowness of that because they don't understand how a fat tail curve works, which I understand. And I'm trying to balance out the numbers for your risk of ruin because when you increase your leverage, your odds of, your account collapsing or blowing out go up. And you have to be aware of that. Now, I've been able to take 0.10 of a Bitcoin and turn it up to 1.15 in over a year and a half using under 1x leverage on one of the small accounts. Now, people have unfortunately seen my video where I turned one Bitcoin into over 100 using extreme leverage of like 20x and up. And, I don't, that's the chances of blowing that account are very high. I'm glad that I'm very accurate and I've been able to, produce these profits with extreme precision. And but there's always a chance that it could go against me. And you can see the growth rate here. And this is the way the fat tail curve works. And it took time to do that. But percentage-wise, the gains have been fantastic. It's just that you don't see them right up front. A fat tail curve. It seems very slow as you're gradually moving up. Now, it exponentially rises simply because of the size. The size after compounding after such an amount from your base starting amount, it starts to expand exponentially. And that's just the nature of the way it would work from your base, from where you're starting. And that's how you develop your ROI and your, but you don't see that up front. You might not see that until 7 months or on down the line before you see the exponential rise simply because of the size. Well, people don't like that. They don't like the slowness of it. And that's because, your minds work in a knob type of all or nothing, type of thinking. And that's an unfortunate way. But, I am a really good trader and I could probably handle the risk up to 3x. But you've got to be aware that your risk of ruin goes way up. And I just want you guys to know that. You get a chance to vote on it, so it's up to you. And we'll let you decide that up to 3x. And I will go on to the update. Right, so here we have Bitcoin. And we can see that we've gone up to the sell zone here. And where do we go from here? It cycled through, it went up here, created this, drops back. Creates more structure, goes all the way up to here, hits this key point up here in the 600 range, pulls all the way back down to here, which is his logical point for supply and demand. So this whole range right here, it's cycled through. And now we've traded back up to here, which is going to be around the 350 area and so forth. If we can move up a little bit more here, fantastic. If we find resistance through here, then we're going to get like a head and shoulders type of pattern. And then failure back down is what we would be looking for. And 61.8 of whatever high that's right there. We'll calculate that later because it hasn't happened. I'm not going to go into that. The other alternative is this. We could see Bitcoin create this pattern here and then make another move all the way up to here, which would be the 6,000 range. And it can do it very quickly, but still, again, you would still be looking for the pullback going forward. It would just give us a dollar cost average and a higher amount of higher numbers, which would be nice as well. The most likely scenario is that we fail within this range right here in this confine between this red line and right up here. Let me draw that in there. That is the most likely scenario. So we're going to state that is the case, and that's what's likely to occur. Similar geometry and the way this is cycled through kind of denote that as being the likelihood. Statistically. So we'll see if that's the case, but there's still a chance that we can power through here based on just statistics. There's about one out of under three chance of the upward movement being higher and going beyond
this level right here. But we're not going to predict. One thing I will show you is this one right here. This was a perfect buy right around that 2.0 to 30 range that I spoke of the other day when it was down there and under. That was just pure manipulation, and you know, I don't even want to go over the story. You could have had a return on this of 100% and then sold half here, and then the other half was just free and clear. And you can target that area up here. Break this down like that. There we go. But we can see that we had the bounce right off of here. This is a kind of a dangerous one because it's full of sketchy people behind that whole Digitex or whatever. And they're looking to be a futures exchange. They had a lot of fanfare because it's going to be free for everybody. I'll give you a clip of the video and you can see how insane it is and whatnot. But now, numbers-wise, they don't really care. It has its greater likelihood it's going to go all the way back up to around 7 cents from that 2 cents and under point. So statistically, you know, the buy where I stated down here and under from that low 2 cent range was correct so far. You can see it. It sticks out to you and whatnot. And looks very appetizing, I guess you can say, if you're one of those Binance traders. Outside of that, we also have, let me go back to BNB. BNB, which is pretty much breaking down. Slowly but surely, it did an exaggeration move all the way up to here, creates this big divergence. This point is the minimum point of which you would expect it to pull back to. It might cycle through and dance around here for a while, but ultimately its downside moves to the 17 short term, probably the 19, the high 19 range, and then ultimately under here, and possibly very much towards this level down here when it's completely done. But that would have to generally follow Bitcoin, which would be when it pulls back fully. And that's the most likely scenario from looking out from everywhere around. Now, let's discuss using higher amounts of leverage because people want bigger profits, and you're gonna get the option. Everybody's gonna vote, and you know, I'm gonna try to make you understand a fat tail curve and how numbers work and compound profits over time, because at first it appears very slow, and then blah blah, you know, you're meandering along, and then numbers start to elevate more and more. It's because you're getting an exponential return from just volatility and trading. But let's go over into that. Let's go over and give you some options.